Should you buy a shockwave device for treating your erectile dysfunction at home? Frankly, I think you should save your money and do something else with it. Maybe a vacation, something that's fun to do. This is a video about low-intensity shockwaves for erectile dysfunction. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. When I started to treat patients with low-intensity shockwaves back in 2017, I was one of the first urologists who did this in my country. In orthopedics, they had been using that method forever for tennis elbows and calcium deposits in the shoulder. And it is very effective for that. But the penis? I was convinced by the available data and bought a machine. By that time, ESWT wasn't approved by the FDA. ESWT, that's the official term for this kind of treatment. It appears to me that the method has become known in the US by its marketing name, Gainswave. So this is what I think about the method after nearly 7 years of experience and thousands of treatment sessions. Shockwaves are effective against erectile dysfunction, but not in all patients. Could it be done at home? I really doubt it. Let's have a look at my machine and some technical specifications. This is a professional Class 3 ESWT machine. As you can see, it is quite bulky. The base unit weighs 17 kilograms and the applicator weighs 500 grams. It has to be, because a lot of technology is needed to generate high-quality shockwaves. And this technology is heavy and bulky. The machine operates on an electromagnetic basis to emit focused shockwaves. Focused shockwaves penetrate deep into the tissues. As opposed to radial shockwaves, focused shockwaves interact with the cells of the body in a much more advanced fashion. The cells are subjected to an enormous pressure surge that occurs within milliseconds. This is followed by negative pressure. The cells are put under a lot of stress, and that's what triggers repair mechanisms. One of the most important parameters for energy output is the EFD, the energy flux density. The unit is millijoules per square millimeter. When looking at the studies that have been performed and the observed effects, the minimal energy needed to achieve any effect on erectile dysfunction appears to be 0.09 millijoules per square millimeter. I have tried different energy levels. Sometimes I go a little higher, but usually I set the machine to 0.096 millijoules per square millimeter. It proved to be a very effective level. So can a machine that you buy on the internet be equally effective? I rather doubt it. There are no technical specifications to be found about them anywhere. What kind of waves are emitted? What kind of energy output does it have? Only a lot of sensational claims and advertising to the max. No data to back up any of those claims. Furthermore, the device is operated at home from users who don't have any medical training. Things that you know how to do always appear easy. But I know from experience that this is not the case. When I educate patients on simple procedures for home use, I am always surprised how difficult it is to them. You wouldn't believe how many mistakes I see when I ask patients for a urine sample from home. Filling this container seems to be rocket science to many. From my perspective, it seems easy, as if even a little child could do it. But that's only because I have done it thousands of times. Patients usually need repeated guidance to learn new procedures, be it the correct injection technique for penile injection therapy or operating the new radiofrequency device I recently talked about. So leaving them alone with home-based ESWT potentially leads to incorrect use of the device. Finally, due to the lack of any technical specifications, how could a tiny machine like that equal a bulky professional device like mine? If it were that easy to put the same technology into a small device, I am sure they would do it. ESWT at the doctor's office is costly because of the high price of the machine and replacing applicators, the costly maintenance and service, and the time needed for treatment. One session takes about 30 minutes at my office. Because not only is it important to look at the energy level, but also at the amount of energy delivered. I am at the higher end of the spectrum here, and that takes a little longer. If you can't afford it, or if you don't want to spend the money for different reasons, buying a machine for home use is likely to turn out as a bad investment. Instead, it might be more fun to spend $1,500 on a vacation. At the beginning of the video, I said that shockwaves don't work for everybody. The problem is, erectile dysfunction has many causes. That makes it different to predict the outcome. What I found is that if I can squeeze the penis like a loaf of fresh sandwich bread and it feels real fluffy, that's a bad sign. Shockwaves don't seem to work with sandwich penises. Psychogenic erectile dysfunction is another reason for the method to fail. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.